Right, hey guys, I'm sorry the lighting mightn't be the best, but it is really dear, so there's no natural light outside of there, as you can see, and I would have timed this video a lot better. Hold on a second, close my door. I would have timed this video a lot better if it hadn't been for everything I've had to do with the deer. So first of all, this morning we had an assembly and it was about what you want to do post 16, so after I've left year 11, what would I personally myself like to go into? Whether it be apprenticeships, college or sixth form. I'm not entirely sure what I want to do, but for this moment I want to say sixth form, I want to do photography, film, media and English language. And after that we went to go this like turntables and you went to different tables, and then after school we had an hour and a half parents even about the mock exams I did in October. And I did okay in everything apart from my history, and I got a 2 instead of a 5. And a 5 is an equivalent to an old C. So, based on all that, I'm going to make this video about things that's wrong about school curriculum, education board, blah, 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 blah. So, one thing is, I can tell you what mitochondria is, and I can tell you well and fine how Henry VIII killed these women. I can tell you about old American history. I'm not from America, but I can tell you about old American history because that comes up in the conflict and tension part. And even though I'm not from America and I don't really need to know America's past, I have to know it. Which is annoying because instead of learning about other countries' pasts, I could be learning about economic stuff. So like, here's my first point. Instead of teaching us stuff they say we need to know, but I don't think we really need to know, like, cool, they used leeches back in the day, but like, prepare us for the future. How do I pay a mortgage? How do I get a mortgage? Like, how will I pay taxes when I leave? Like, I was talking about once I'm 16, I want to look for a student house to share with Jasmine. And all good and that, but if I don't know how to get a mortgage and I don't know how to go get a flat, it's no good and it's never going to be any good, because that's just something I'm going to have to figure out all the way throughout my life. Hopefully, if I get married and my significant other could know all that stuff. And then another point is about that they tell you how the reproductive system works. Like, I know that because I've got an implant in, it creates a mucus plug in the cervix, which tricks your body into thinking you're pregnant, basically, so you can't, it doesn't let anything go up. And it doesn't let any blood come down. I can tell you that, but they don't give you anything of like, when you do decide to have a child, here's what you do. So it's all like, here's how not to get pregnant, here's how you get pregnant, but there's no, or when you decide you want a child, we're not going to teach you how to look after that child. You see, the problem with kids is the parents. Like, teach the kids how to parent, and there'll be no more problem. That's all I'm saying. And another thing is, this year they're a help, but year 11 I've had to figure out it by myself, and it's all fair and good. Giving us shits like that. But what year 11 is going? Right, I've got loads of revision. I'm going to write out what 3 careers I like most. This goes nowhere, but you know, it's there. What I do think is helpful is they can tell you how you can get money depending on if you want to go. You do. So I can get money if you want a sixth form. That is our sixth form logo. Boring. I think that's called Vulnerable Burst Videos. So you can only get student PA in sixth form if you are one of the following. Students in care, including unaccompanied asylum seeking students. I don't get that. Does that mean I have to be a psycho? Lonely? I'm sorry if I offended someone. I really am. Students who are care leavers. I don't know what that means either. Students in receipt of income support or the equivalent universal credit in their own right. And students in receipt of both employment support allowances, universal credit and disability living allowance in their own right. So let's say for the universal credit in their own right. I know my nana gets universal credit for looking after me because I don't live with my mum and dad. But it is in their own right. So I'd have to like sign up for universal credit and bloody bloody blah, and there's enough pressure going on for year 11s anyways to be like, do I qualify for this? Like, and then it's all fair and good this year. Oh, well, you can go to universities after college at sixth form. You can crack on and do whatever you want to do. But there's a university I'm interested in, but it's like 9.5 grand a year. And it's all fair, so you can get a student loan. Then what if the university doesn't take us anywhere, and then I have to pay back all those loans and I'm going to be skint. Say I do get a good job, right? Say I do get a really good job. So yeah, this pursues somewhere and I'm doing really well. Would that still be enough to pay for the 9.5 grand I've lent? The 9.5 grand I've given to university to tell me what I've already learned in 3 years of photography, and then I want to learn 2 years of film media and photography in sixth form. So then you people go, well, don't do photography and film media. If you do English, you're going to learn a lot more stuff in uni. No, you're not. You're just going to be relearning what you've already learned. And I know this video is a bit of a ramble, but I'm just saying, like, I feel like year 11s should be given a bit more help. It's alright to see you feel helped because they're giving you extra homework or they're helping you in lessons, but if you think about it, once we leave school, we don't really know how to get anywhere with it. You might be a smarty pants and bloody bloody blah, but do you know how to pay your mortgage? Do you know how to pay taxes? Do you know what taxes need to be paid? Here's another thing. I was watching Boy in the Band's video, another one who helped. What you call it, on a diss track on Vice Gum. Yeah, his video. He was saying how they're going to spend a lot of time dedicating it to teaching us first aid or how to see the simple signs of someone having a mental health disorder. Or they could spend that time dedicating the teacher stuff that we need. And it's just not fair. Like, it's all right to teach us American history, or that mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, but it's not really helpful for real life. And I think my maths teacher said to me, Lydia, it's cool, we're teaching pi, you'll learn pi, 3.148, not entirely sure. She said, you're not going to need it post 16. And what post 16 is once you finish your 11, if you're in the UK, you are 16. And that's anything you want to do after 16. And this post 18, if anything you want to do after 18. So I think I was talking to one teacher that I've been doing this. And her reply is, shouldn't you be spending more time revising this certain subject? That certain subject has nothing to do with what I want to pursue in life. And I was basically told to give up a hobby and something I want to do full time for her lesson. And it's like, school's cool and that, and you can get many certificates. Like, in year 9 I got a C in computing. Right there, it says I got a C and the misspelled went in. So I can get a C in computing in year 9 and I can get equivalent of C's in English at this time, and I'm meeting the minimum expected good for the end of year 11, now in year 11 for photography. And I don't like it this day, but awards after awards after awards, I prided myself most of you do school to do well and stuff like that, but what's the point? It's alright to see you. I'm trying to learn the curriculum, I'm good at English, I know my science, I can do computing if I need it to. But it's going to be no use when I leave school, and I guess this is what this little video is about, that the education board, if anyone from the education board is watching, I think you just need to dedicate some time at teaching us real things we need. So I need to put this back on my wall and it's going to be a heartache, but I love you all and I hope you're having a superb night. Mwah. Oh, I nearly dropped you.